Lufthansa Technik Philippines, the joint venture between Lufthansa Macro Asia and German airline Lufthansa Technik, eyeing to tap the Philippine Sovereign Wealth Fund to help finance its expansion plans at the Clark International Airport in Pampanga. The firm wants to invest 8 billion pesos to build a second hangar, which will cover a 2-hectare lot in Clark Airport. The project is expected to complement LTP's existing 23-hectare technical base and hangar at the Nino Aquino International Airport in Manila. The project hopes to provide 400 new jobs to Filipinos during its target 2-year construction period. Aside from this project, Lufthansa Technik Philippines said a phase 2 expansion in Clark or another airport in Bulacan or Stanley Point may also be possible. President Marcos earlier this week met with LTP officials during his working visit in Germany. Czech Republic President Petr Pavel affirming his government's commitment to expanding its economic cooperation with the Philippines. Pavel made that remark during President Marcos's 4-day state visit to the Central European country. Pavel adds a number of Czech businesses are interested in investing in the Philippines, covering technology transfer and funding future projects. It's also keen on establishing food cooperation with the Philippines, with Czech's agriculture minister visiting Manila soon. The European nation has been one of the country's partners in the dairy industry, having provided assistance and technical expertise in the sector's supply chain.
There is strong will and determination to further expand the framework that is built on framework agreements and other documents. Future meetings will continue with that during Mr. President's visit in the Czech Republic in Prague, but also in the future. Very soon, our Minister of Agriculture shall visit the Philippines with a numerous delegation of our businessmen with specific, particular plans to offer. We also have companies that are involved in defense industry, manufacturing, then in farming and agriculture, science, technology, energy sector, power sector. Many of these businesses do have a particular specific plans for their future cooperation, potential cooperation with the Philippines.
President Marcos, for his part, is hopeful the Czech Republic will help the Philippines modernize its armed forces as Manila faces increasing Chinese aggression.
The armed forces of the Philippines is undergoing a modernization program. And under that modernization program, there will be a great deal of procurement that needs to be done to modernize our forces and to modernize our capabilities. And the Czech Republic has always been an important part of that development, of that evolution. And we are hoping that that will continue, not only at its present level, but at a higher level.
Farmers in Oriental Mindoro, where crops have been drying up due to the El Nino phenomenon, are facing a new threat. Army worms, locally known as harabas. Farmers there say the infestation of army worms has forced them to harvest onions prematurely as they try to save their crops before the pests consume them entirely. This, in turn, leads to lower prices of onions because of their poor quality and smaller size. Farmers now crying for help, saying they've tried various pesticides but to no avail. The Commission on Audit has ruled PAGCOR's controversial use of intelligence funds was justified. The Commission on Thursday lifted its notice of disallowance against cash advances of the state gaming operator in relation to its confidential and intelligence activities in 2012, amounting to over 254 million pesos. The disallowance issued last October 2013 was based on two things, including the 48 million CAF that was dispersed in 2012 without the approval of the late President Benigno Aquino III, as well as the lack of documents connected to its intelligence operations under the 2012 Save the House project. But upon re-examination, the COA found the Office of the President did allow the use of the CAF in a letter dated April 2012. The Commission also found that the agency was compliant with the documentary requirements for its confidential activities. A majority of Filipinos satisfied with the performance of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. A survey conducted by the social weather stations last December shows 65% were pleased with Marcos's leadership, but 21% were displeased. Another 14% were undecided. The figures translate to a net satisfaction rating of plus 47, which SWS classifies as good. That's 3 points higher than the plus 44 rating Marcos received in September. A closer look at the data, however, reveals a lower satisfaction rate in Mindanao, where the base of former President Rodrigo Duterte is located. Motorists brace for another mixed bag of fuel price adjustments for next week. Based on estimates from the Energy Department, gasoline could see no change or a slight increase in price, while diesel is expected to see a drop of anywhere between 20 and 40 centavos per liter. Kerosene too could see no change or a small rollback of about 10 centavos per liter. The agency cites U.S. forecast of rising production this year and the next for the slight rollback.